Welcome back to my channel. My name is Buhle, and if you're new, welcome to my tribe. Please subscribe, and if you're coming back for another video, thank you so much. So because June is here and winter is here, it's only appropriate that I do a winter hair care tips. So in this video, I'll be giving you 10 hair care tips that you can incorporate into your hair routine to make sure that your hair is moisturized, it's hydrated, it's healthy, it's popping, it's lush, it's beautiful, it's amazing, sweetie. So without further ado, let's get right into the video. So tip number one is to use water. Amanzi goes for zonke, that's what we're saying, is Xhosa, goes for zonke. Water can clean, can heal, can purify, it can cook, it can do a lot of things, and it can make your hair healthy and hydrated. It is the only way actually to hydrate your hair and to keep your hair hydrated. Essentially, you can't keep your hair moisturized, you can't keep your hair hydrated. You need to keep hydrating your hair and keep moisturizing your hair. So that's very important, to spray your hair with water-based products or water. Every day, products should be water-based. You as well as a person should be drinking lots of water, apparently 2 liters a day, but make sure you drink at least 1.5 or a liter of water a day to keep yourself hydrated, to keep your hair healthy. Because if you're not hydrated, if you're not healthy, the first things to suffer is your hair and your nails, because according to your body, those are not that important. So make sure that you're hydrated and you're well nourished. Then tip number two, which actually goes hand in hand with water, is the greenhouse effect. So you could incorporate this by actually not covering your hair when you shower or when you steam, because we still have the virus here. So when you steam or when you shower, keep your hair open so that the steam can actually penetrate your cuticle and open up your cuticle, so that when you do spray your hair with water, it will easily accept and absorb the water and the moisture. And number three, which also goes hand in hand with the greenhouse effect, so instead of leaving your hair open, if you're someone that suffers from dry ends, even though you've trimmed your ends, you could try the bagging method. I personally haven't tried it, but there's a lady I follow on Instagram, Clean Beauty Botanics. I'll leave her Instagram here. She does a lot of DIY, natural, almost vegan friendly, I would say vegan friendly hair care routines or hair care recipes. So you should follow her if you're interested. But she tries this, bagging method. So you apply hot oil to your ends, to section your hair actually. You apply hot oil to your ends, and then you cover that with a shower cap or with a plastic bag. So just to steam and to focus the moisture and the hydration onto your ends, and you leave it overnight. So that's a hair care tip you could do. I'll be trying out soon, and I'll let you know in another video. I don't know when, but I'll let you know. And number four is switching from your light creams to using your heavier creams, such as the Native Child Milk and Honey. That's what I'm using currently. Even the Vatica Naturals Leave-In Cream is quite thick, as well as, or using shea butter to actually help moisturize and seal in your ends. These will actually do more moisture, or give you more moisture, or seal in better than your light creams. Your light creams are more suitable for your hotter and your warmest months. And then number five, which goes hand in hand with number four, is sealing your moisture in. It is very important to seal your moisture in after you've hydrated your hair. So I still, even though it's winter, I still recommend using your light oils, such as your grapeseed oil, coconut oil, argan oil, and avocado oil, sunflower. Those are light oils because they penetrate your cuticle better, and they won't cause product buildup, and they won't weigh your hair down, especially if you're going to be using something that's heavy already, like your creams or your shea butter. Rather use a light oil. Number six, when you do your wash day routine, when you do your wash day, opt for doing a co-wash instead of doing shampoos. And if you have to shampoo, rather use a moisturizing shampoo instead of a clarifying shampoo, one with its sulfates, as well as pre-poo when you do shampoo. This will help keep your hair hydrated and moisturized and ensure that your natural oils do not get stripped off your hair. And then when you do shampoo your hair, which leads to number 7, make sure that you deep condition, especially using moisture-based deep conditioners. There's a whole lot that you can choose from, so deep condition more regularly, weekly even, if you can. Deep condition weekly, yes please, which will actually just aid in adding the hydration and the moisture in. Number 8, which I spoke about in my previous video, trim your ends to make sure that your hair is not dry and to prevent your split ends from traveling up your hair shaft and causing your hair to further lose moisture. Number 9 is a protective style. So this is a very good time to protect the style and just to kind of also get a break from your hair, because I need a break from my hair. It's a lot, but do a protective style. Protective style could be braids, could be twists, could be with or without fiber, could be bantu knots. I did bantu knots. That's why I have this cute ass curl out. So cute. So bantu knots, your wig. Wig is actually it's also a great protective style. Cornrows, whatever hides or tucks in your hair and your ends is a protective style. And then number 10, when you do your protective style, ensure that it's a low manipulation style that does not pull or cause tension from your hair, does not weigh your hair down, it's not too heavy for your hair or your scalp, just to prevent injibaba. Yeah, we don't want injibaba, please. So prevent also when you do your protective styles that with a fiber or fagela, ensure that they don't touch your edges, they don't touch your baby hair, they don't pull on your hairline, and that they are gentle to prevent tension on your hair and to prevent harsh treatment from your hair. Another reason why you shouldn't do a hairstyle that is too heavy or that uses a fiber and needs a lot of fiber is so that when you do spray your hair or you moisturize your hair, because even though you have a protective style, you still need to do your lock method or moisturize your hair. So you need to make sure that you can still, the spray or whatever method you use to moisturize your hair can still penetrate and reach your hair. When your hair is dirty or your scalp is dirty, you do have access to your scalp so that you can clean it and you can wash it and moisturize it. When you also do your protective style, I think this is a bonus tip. When you do your protective style, ensure that you moisturize your hair, that your hair is properly hydrated, it is lush, it is healthy. Because what's the point of protecting dry hair? And more especially or worse, you may wear skin when flowers or wens are in the enzyme, okay? It means your hair is dry already inside. Number 2, you can't even reach your hair to moisturize it or keep it hydrated. It's a mazarina. So make sure when you do your protective style, your hair is moisturized and it is in a good state, it is healthy, so that your hair also grows and retains its length and retains its moisture. But other than that, that's all from me. Those are all my tips that I have and that I'll be using this winter. If you have any other tips, please comment down below, share them with us. If you have any other comments, suggestions, comment section down below. Other than that, I'll see you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe. Bye.